figure out, like, just like add in a little bit at the as a at a time, and then if you guys need more, then you can put it later. So I'm gonna show you guys right now, and then add in the vinegar to make the chemical reaction take place. As you can see, it's already bubbling a little bit, and if you put in too much, then it's gonna bubble and like flow over the top. But kind of like that. Hopefully you can see it, but I put in just a little bit too much, but it's okay if you want to do a little cleanup job. But it just looks like this, and then now, as you can see, the corn, how the corn kernels have gone up to the top. The corn kernels have gone all the way to the top, and they're pushed by gas that's created in the chemical reaction. And then when I put it down, then they go back down, and this is the dancing corn experiment, because they keep on dancing around in the solution. So you can see them dancing.
Make sure you guys show us your experiments once you have it finished.
Yeah. So you can show us what your dancing corn looks like right now. And so we can all share our dancing corn and have them dance together. Yeah. So it'll settle down a little bit, but once you like pick it up, then it starts like doing more stuff. And see, as you can tell, like when they were on the table, all the corn kernels are at the top. And then when I picked it up, now they're like going to the bottom, but they're dancing a little bit right here. So Andrew, do you want to give the science lesson?
If you guys are wondering how this happens in science, here's a little bit of background. So in this experiment, it's a chemical reaction between an acid and a base. And an acid is determined by, acid and bases are determined by pH level. So pH starts from 1 and goes to 14. If the pH level of a substance is below 7, it's considered a acid. And if the pH level is above 7, then it's considered a base. And if the pH level is at 7, then it's a neutral substance. And in this experiment, the vinegar is the acid and the base is the baking soda. So when the two are combined, they make a gas called carbon dioxide, which pushes all of the popcorn kernels to the top. And it produces an eruption that you can see, which makes the kernels dance. And carbon dioxide is a gas, and when it rises, it escapes through the jar, which you see as bubbles. So that's what makes the corn dance. And over time, you can do the experiment over and over again if you want to see it again.
So you can see the carbon dioxide bubbles pushing the corn kernels up to the top to make them dance. And also, if you're here for extra credit, our code word is technology. So yeah, this is a one that I just did a few minutes ago, and there's still a bunch of bubbles, but it's just not as strong because the chemical reaction like is still taking place. But yours can last a little longer. Oh, Jalen, do you have a question?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, what is it?
So I make an ass sound in my theater class.
Ooh, that looks cool. That looks really cool. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That bowl.
Yeah, that's really cool.
That looks really cool. Did you do the dancing corn? If you guys did it, then you guys can show us like your versions of it.
Yeah.
Let's see. That looks really good, Thomas, guys.
I threw it in the baggie, so I just used the bag.
Yeah, Did you guys have fun? Did you guys like it?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Welcome. Bye. You guys can start leaving and going to your next session now. I hope you guys enjoyed it and had fun doing the dancing corn experiment with us.
Thank you. Thank you for buying the STEM box.
Of course.
No problem.
Thank you guys. Bye. Hi, Liz. Oh my god.